So you already know two oxidative phases. One, there is no decarboxylation here. You can see only production of NADPH, and this is a very this is done by very important enzyme, glucose-6-phosphate-dehydrogenase. And second step, you can see decarboxylation also have to happen. This is basically oxidative decarboxylation. Okay, and then there is dehydrogenation. So here also production of one NADPH, and this is formed by also this is also done by dehydrogenase. This is also done by dehydrogenase. The substrate name plus dehydrogenase, 6-phosphoglucolate dehydrogenase is done by. This is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So this reaction is done by. Why we have shown this three reaction? Because, you know, I've told you this six of this will form five of fructose. And that is why we have to show, because exchange carbon transfer happens in next step. So carbon transfer happens by transketolase and transaldolase. So now, I will tell you, this may seem a very complicated reaction. Don't worry about it. If you can see, there is only three steps. So first step, this is the ribulose 5-phosphate conversion of ribulose into xylose, okay, and ribose, okay, because this transfer of carbon happens between keto to aldose, from keto to aldo. So you can see here, three steps are only, one step, two step, and then this is third step. Only three-step process. It may seem complicated, but only three-step process. In that also, first and last step, both are by transketolase, vitamin B1 containing enzyme. Transketolase. Okay, this two. And middle is trans. Only one place you will see transaldolase. Okay, so now you can see this is five carbon. From five carbon, three carbon, because ketolase, two carbon transfer. So this five carbon, from this two carbon will be subtracted, you can see. So this will become three carbon. Now two carbon will be transferred here. So this becomes, this three carbon, let me change the color. This is three carbon, and this become 5+2, 7 carbon. You don't have to memorize, that is a good thing. Just see this. Transfer. And now second step comes transaldolase. Aldolase means three carbon transfer. So what will happen? This you can see glyceraldehyde. Can you see the glyceraldehyde here? And that is how through this glyceraldehyde it is connected. And now this, from the 7 carbon, three carbon is transferred. Minus three carbon. So three carbon goes here. 3+3, 6 carbon. This becomes fructose 6. One fructose 6-phosphate is formed. Now this, because of this erythrose 5-phosphate, and again erythrose is a aldose sugar, it requires next keto sugar. So next keto sugar is xylulose. So from xylulose again transketolase transferred 2 carbon, because it is 4 carbon compound. This transfer 2 carbon compound from here to here. So this becomes what? Erythrose 4+2, it becomes 6 carbon fructose. And here, because it is 5 carbon, when it removed 4 carbon, it becomes this glyceraldehyde. And you know, this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate can convert into glucose through opposite process of glycolysis. Glucose directly through fructose, because fructose, it can directly convert into fructose, 1-phosphate, 6-phosphate. So that is what you can see the connection here. So this can convert into fructose. So this is connected at two places, that is why this is called shunt pathway.